Hello, welcome to D-Light Channel, Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative, as we continue our conversation on entrepreneurship made simple. I am glad you are able to join me this week. Last week, we introduced the concept of organizational life cycle. And what were we saying? We were saying that as you are starting out on your journey to becoming an entrepreneur, remember that you will be going through different points in this life cycle. And each point has its own peculiarities, and what we'll be trying to do will be to trace out these peculiarities. Why? Because we believe that once you know and you are equipped with the knowledge, you are in a better position to take the right actions, the right decisions, all in the name of ensuring that whatever you have started, you are able to finish, and you very soon can start living your dream. Where are we starting from? We are starting from the startup phase. What are the characteristics of this phase? This is the phase where all the things we've said before you have done. You have thought through the business. What problem are you trying to solve? What name would you call it? You've registered. You probably have a domain name. We hope that by this time, you have already succeeded in acquiring your first few customers. You've made a few sales. You probably have also earned a few dollars or naira into your account. And then you're on your way to wherever you want to get to. Now, at this point, it is necessary to be aware of the variables of this point, the landmines that exist therein, and how you can avoid them. So let's go through them. Number one of the first thing you must make sure you put in place in this phase is a feedback channel. You need to be deliberate to set up a listening channel, a medium, a mechanism through which you can hear what the market is saying. Because when you were in the boardroom, when you were inside your room, when you were in your head conceiving the idea, conceiving the product, you had certain assumptions, certain expectations. And it is very easy for entrepreneurs to fall into the trap of trying to sell what they have to the market as against finding what the market wants and then providing it. I say that again. It is very easy for entrepreneurs to fall into the trap of trying to sell what they have designed to the market as against finding out what the market wants and being in the position to provide it. If you have read the book
Blue Ocean,
I hope I get to dwell on it further down the line, you will realize that you will be creating new possibilities for yourself if you get to the position where you can increase value and reduce cost at the same time. And how do you get this to happen? You will find that there are certain things that the market is currently doing that we'll gladly do without for a reduced price or for an improved experience. How do you then get to the point where you know what to drop and what to add? That is when you have a deliberate setup to listen to the market. Technology makes this a lot easier through your social media channel, through deliberate feedback solicitation, and through what you get from your customer interaction. Be deliberate to harvest and harness all the feedback you can get about whatever you are trying to do. And it is not just something to be gathered and dumped. You need to synthesize them. Not everything you hear will be useful. Not everybody understands all the variables that you are running with. So, I am not saying that everything you hear you use, but you must be able to distill, find the ones that push you in the direction that you need to go, and immediately adopt them, and the ones that are not so useful, appreciate them for what they are, and then put them where they belong, inside the trash can, and keep optimizing. One thing you cannot afford to do is to block your ears, block your eyes, and just keep running based on the model you had in your mind before you started. Now that you are in the market, let the market validate your ideas for you and listen and adopt as you go. That would be number one. Number two will be about the culture of the organization. Accountants are toying with some very interesting concepts these days. They are saying that on your balance sheet, there should just be two things, culture and people. Because at the end of the day, these are the two critical variables that define everything you eventually become. So let's talk about culture. Culture, as you know, is the way, habits, manner, attitudes, orientation that defines a group of people. It's the same for your organization. At the very, very beginning, you need to be clear as to what the culture of your organization should be. And believe me, it is easier when the company is made up of 3 people, 5, 7 people, because you can meet them, you can reach them, you can influence them, you can model what you want in front of them, and it is easier for them to understand. If you don't start early in this journey, you either find it very difficult, if not impossible, or it will be very, very expensive for you to do it. So, what we are saying is that define the variables of your organizational culture. And one of the easiest ways to do that is to go through your values and create what we call value behavior matrix, where you break it down into the specifics of the behaviors that you expect in the organization. And you must then live up to the expectation by modeling the same type of behavior. Values like respect, value like integrity, value like customer centricity, value like passion, whatever it is that you think are important to your organizational culture, you need to establish them very, very early in the beginning of the organization. And you will notice that I'm even placing this before the people. Why? Because if you go to the next item I think you need to worry about at this point of the organization, which are the people, defining the culture helps you to know who you should hire. Yes, at the beginning, you may just be looking for just anybody who is able to support you as you start. But once you get stabilized in this startup phase and you have your first set of customers, first set of orders, first set of cash, and you are beginning to look like a business that can thrive, then it is necessary for you to ensure that you are deliberate in who you hire. And how do you know who to hire? The person to hire must be somebody who is fit for the culture that you are defining. And that leads me to something I wanted to share with you about people. When it comes to hiring people, you will always hear experienced recruiters telling you that hire for attitude and train for skills. It's always better for you to find somebody whose attitude fits the organizational culture you have defined, and then train them for whatever they need to know or know how to do in your organization. Why? It is easier to teach skills than attitudes. So, I've said 3 things. Number 1 is the feedback mechanism. Number 2 is the culture definition. Number 3 is the people. And then number 4 is now a structure. From the get-go, you need to start a process where people in your organizations have clear portfolios. You must spend time to define who is responsible for what. Why is that necessary? If you ever hope to go beyond just self-employment, and I think I've said this before in the previous video, that we are not talking about self-employment. We are talking about entrepreneurship, where you build an enterprise. And the meaning of an enterprise is that ultimately down the line, it can run without you being present, and you can go to bed knowing that you have built a system that can run itself, that can check itself, that can balance itself. The very first step in that direction is to define portfolios for every member of your team. Never mind that at the beginning like this, it may not be cut and dry. There may be a lot of overlap, but as much as you can, right from the beginning, define portfolio. And don't let it exist verbally in your head or by conversation. Write it down. It can be one pager. It can be a half. It can even be half page. Let it be that when you hire, whoever you are hiring, has an idea of, this is my portfolio. Even if there are overlaps, as the business is continuing, there will be points in the organization's operation that will point out that there are overlaps and you can deal with that. Finally, as I try to wrap up, you need to start from the beginning to design and implement a form of performance management system. I'm not asking you to do any heavy duty, balance scorecard, 360 degree or anything like that. But let two things be clear as you are starting. Number one is that you are clear as to what is the expectation of each role, and you communicate it to them and you let them understand. And number two is that you are deliberate to reward and to punish whoever is not meeting those criteria. It could be ad hoc, it could be once a month, twice a year, per project, depending on what you do and how you find it convenient. But let it be clear in your team's mind that you are not just rewarding showing up at work, but you are out to reward productivity. In addition, let it not just be about empty promises, because those are the things that either reinforce or damage your culture. If you promise cake, make sure you give it. If you promise a cane, make sure you give it. It doesn't even have to be big. All it takes is that accommodate them in whatever you are doing. Because if you are not fair in your performance management system, you will build resentment. So whatever system you decide to implement, let fairness be your watchword. I can go on and on, and like I keep saying, it is not possible to cover all the content in a short video. Even this one is too long for my liking, but please bear with me. So if there are other things you'd like me to share with you, reach out on the email address on your screen, reach out through the Telegram channel, drop a comment for us online and we will connect with you. And let's help you break this down so that you stand with a very solid foundation for the enterprise that you are trying to build. That will be all for this week. Next week, we will be moving to the next phase, and I'm sure you do not want to miss it. Share with everybody that you think needs to hear about this, and whatever you do, don't miss next week's episode. Always remember as well that T-Mac is my name, and all we are trying to do in this channel is to make a little difference. Thanks for being here this week, and see you next week. Bye.